Hello students, welcome to today's session. So in today's session we were discussing about linear homogeneous equation differential equation or linear non-homogeneous differential equations. We were trying to find the solutions using different methods, right? In our previous class we were discussing how to find the solution by using linear parametric forms, and in that we have seen if the exponential term is there, then by shifting the exponential term, how we can find the solution, how we can find the particular solution for the given differential equation. Today in that same thing we will see the operator 1 by f of d. Using this, how we can find the solution, how we can find the particular solution for the given equation, we'll see that. We know that f of d into e power ax is equal to e power ax into f of a. By our previous classes, we have already observed this. And one more thing, d minus a whole power n into x to the power n into e power ax, it is nothing but equal to n factorial into e power ax. Now what if 1 by f of t into e power ax is there, how we can solve this? That is nothing but 1 by f of d into e power ax is nothing but 1 by f of a into e power ax. So what is the value of a? You have to substitute in the place of in the equation f of d. So f of d, it is replaced by f of a. So we'll solve one of the problems so that you can understand it properly. So this thing we can do only when the f of a is not equal to 0. Suppose f of a is equal to 0, then there is one more case for that. Okay, we'll solve the problem where f of a is not equal to 0 and check how to solve the problem. So it is given that solve d square minus 3d plus 2 into y is equal to e power 4x. So complementary solution, you know to find that. That is nothing but the same procedure repeats what we have learned in our previous classes, finding the auxiliary equation, then finding the roots of the auxiliary equation and writing the complementary solution. So auxiliary equation is m square minus 3m plus 2 is equal to 0. So while you solve this quadratic equation, you will get two roots, that is m is equal to 1 and m is equal to 2. So the complementary solution is yc is equal to c1 e power x plus c2 e power 2x. Now the thing left is we have to find the particular solution. How to find the particular solution? So we are using the method, that is one operator method, 1 by f of d. So 1 by f of d is nothing but the given thing d square minus 3d plus 2 into e power 4x. So here in the place of a, what is the value of a? It is nothing but 4. So if I substitute here 4, I'll not get the value f of a equal to 0. Clearly I'll get f of a not equal to 0. So the thing is, we can say replace it by f of a. So I'll get 4 square minus 3 into d, that is 4, plus 2 into e power 4x. So while you simplify this, you will get it as 1 by 16 minus 12 plus 2 into e power 4x. So clearly when you simplify this, you will get it as 1 by 6 into e power 4x. So next, how to write the solution, general solution? General solution is nothing but y is equal to yc plus yp. Yc is complementary solution, c1 e power x plus c2 e power 2x plus the obtained particular solution, that is 1 by 6 into e power 4x. So in this method, when f of a is not equal to 0, we can find the solution, particular solution, in this way, and thus we can write the general solution. Now suppose f of a is equal to 0, then how to find, what is the method for that? So suppose f of a is equal to 0, clearly it will have an operator, right? D minus a will be the factor of that given equation f of d. So I'll just note down the formula of that. So there is a derivation for that which will be discussed in the class. So how to find the how you obtain the formula will be discussed later. So I'll write down the formula, that is nothing but 1 by phi of d into d minus a whole power n into e power ax is equal to x power n into e power ax divided by n factorial into phi of a. So here also we'll solve one problem so that you can understand how to solve the problem when we get f of a equal to 0. What is that f of a getting equal to 0? For that I'll consider the problem d square into d minus 2 into y is equal to e power 2x. Okay, this is a question given. So clearly you can observe here 2, right? While I substitute here 2, I'll get equal to 0. So we can't find the particular solution using our previous method, right? So here we are using the different method, that is nothing but we are using this formula. So complementary solution I'll not discuss here, as you already know how to find the complementary solution. Directly I'll move on to particular solution. So particular solution, that is nothing but yp is equal to 1 by d square into d minus 2 into e power 2x. Observe here, while I substitute the a value, I'll not get here value, right? I'll get it as equal to 0. So the remaining term is what? Other than this, that is nothing but d square. So this d square, I'm considering it as phi of d as d square. Clear? So how to solve it further? Think that and try yourself. We'll discuss this in our next class. Thank you.